Hi viewers, welcome to our channel. Today we will talk about parvoviral enteritis in dogs, one of the most fatal and common disease seen in puppies. It can also be seen in adult dogs, but not that dangerous. As the name suggests, it's a viral disease which is caused by canine parvo virus. The most affected age group is puppies within 6 weeks to 6 months. For the first few weeks of life, puppies born to mother with canine parvovirus antibodies are protected. But later, as the maternally acquired antibody wanes, susceptibility to infection increases. Stress, example from weaning, overcrowding, malnutrition, etc. Concurrent intestinal parasitism or enteric pathogen infection have been associated with more severe clinical illness. Mode of transmission. The virus is shed in feces of infected dogs within 4 to 5 days of exposure, throughout the period of illness and for nearly 10 days after recovery. Infection is acquired through direct oral or nasal contact with virus-containing feces or indirectly through contact with virus-contaminated fomites, example environment, personnel, equipment. Clinical findings. Clinical signs generally develop within 5 to 7 days of infection. Initially, the signs may be non-specific like lethargy, weakness, loss of appetite, fever, with progression to vomiting and hemorrhagic diarrhea, that is bloody feces with foul smell, within 24 to 48 hours. The vomitus will be frothy, yellow-colored, resulting in severe dehydration. In certain cases, animals will be unable to get up and eventually death happens if not treated on time. And in case of treatment also, supportive therapy can only be given as it is a viral disease. So antibiotics and fluids will be given and that your veterinarian will take care of. Coming to diagnosis, diagnosis is mainly through the clinical signs and nowadays parvo kits are available in the market. Even though it is a little bit expensive, it can be a confirmatory diagnosis. In the prevention part, isolation of sick puppies is very important. Proper cleaning and disinfection of contaminated place. The kennel, shelter, cages, equipment, etc. should be cleaned, disinfected and dried twice before reuse. Never bring new puppy for a period of 1 month after an infected puppy had been there at a home. Vaccination of mother dog before mating is very important. Vaccination of healthy pup at 45 days of age. Avoid overcrowding, that is, don't get a puppy from an overcrowded place. Also, if you have many puppies at home, keep them at a distance until protected with vaccine. Regular deworming of the mother and pup. As always said, prevention is better than cure. So, it's better to go for all the vaccinations at proper time and follow the schedule of vaccination properly so that your puppy will be healthy and protected against such kind of deadly viral diseases. Thanks for watching.